Hello there, I'm Darren Newsom, senior analyst for Telvent DTN based out of Omaha, Nebraska. I was given the opportunity to write in the February issue of SFO Magazine a trade of the month, and so I spent a great deal of time looking at the different commodities, the different commodity sectors, and there's a great many markets that do make major moves, or at least start major moves in February. But one really jumped out at me, and that is the cotton market. Cotton tends to post its seasonal high in the month of February before falling off. And here's what I'm looking at. If we look at the five-year seasonal index for the cotton market, what we see is that it rallies on a weekly close basis about 16% from the last week of January through the last week of February. This is one of the strongest moves that we see in commodities, regardless of sectors. Now, coming off of a 2011 where cotton was rated about as poorly of a performer as there was in commodities, losing about 37% for the year, it looks like we could start to build some momentum in the market. Now, given this 16% rally and when where we're trading in cotton early in 2012, this would project to a high price of about $1.16. Now, if we look at the weekly chart for March cotton alone, we're talking about the March cotton contract here. If we look at its weekly contract, what we see is that $1.16 is right up in a technical area between the 62.8 and the 67% retracement level of the previous downtrend. This is significant. This means that the market has had a great deal of support. We've had a great number of buyers coming in. We could possibly see investment money coming back in March. It's a short-term trade. Again, basically from the beginning of January through the end of February, but doing most of its rallying just in the month of February alone. So from a seasonal point of view, certainly looks like the market could perform well. From a technical point of view, based on its weekly chart, also looks like it could perform well. Now, one other thing that it's going to need to see, we always talk about market structure. We're going to have to see the other side of the market become bullish as well, and that is the fundamental side. And we can tell what they're doing by looking at the spread charts, by looking at how the futures contracts line up against each other. And if we see the black line, I know there's three lines on this chart, but if we look at the black line, that is the March to May future spread. And we see that this spread is still in an inverted or backwardation situation. In other words, the March contract's higher priced than the May. This means that there are bullish fundamentals in the March cotton contract that, if you know, combined with these other technical signals, could really provide the market a great deal of support. And this is when we normally see the stronger retracement levels. Remember, we talked about going back up to the 62.8 or the 67% retracement. This is what triggers that, is a strong bullish commercial outlook indicated by the inverted future spread. So add all this together, certainly looks like the trade of the month for February could be being long the March cotton contract, risking below the 84 cent level, which was its winter of 2011 low. So not a lot of risk if we can get it bought correctly, if we can get it bought down just a little bit, see it rally. Looks like a pretty good trade from risk reward. Again, this is Darren Newsom, Telvent DTN senior analyst with the February trade of the month.